Guests at a downtown St. Louis hotel complain about bed bug bites and poor housekeeping during their three-night stay for a cheerleading camp. Now, the hotel is denying any problems with the bugs. Cheerleaders from Potosi and Farmington High Schools say they complained last night to management at the Millennium Hotel in downtown St. Louis about getting bitten by bugs. One of the girls shared pictures with us of mold growing on wallpaper in her room and a flooded bathtub that did not drain all day. The girl said their rooms were never cleaned during their stay, and they had to put trash out in the hallway in an effort to get it cleaned up. News 11's Betsy Bruce has more now on why it took until 2 a.m. for the cheerleaders to get assigned new rooms.
What mostly concerns me would be the mold, first of all, because our girls were getting sick. Like, they couldn't even cheer, or they couldn't compete with us because they were sick. And then, secondly, it was the bugs biting the girls. Yeah, I did see the bugs. I saw the ones that were in my bed whenever the paramedic was inspecting them. She pointed them out, and they're a good size, and they have legs.
Were you bitten?
No, I wasn't, but some of my friends were.
The Millennium Hotel responded to the bed bug complaint with this prepared statement.
Last night, the Millennium Hotel St. Louis received a complaint from a guest regarding an insect bite. We promptly relocated the guests and some other concerned members of the guest group to other rooms. The pest control company inspected the guest rooms this morning and found no traces of any insects.
Can you say at all how regularly the pest company visits your hotel?
I'm reading the statement right here, but thank you so much.
The St. Louis City Health Department has sent a community sanitation inspector to check out these complaints at the hotel. No additional comment from the hotel was offered about the cleanliness issue. The students and their adult advisors were here for a three-day cheerleading camp and competition. In downtown, Betsy Bruce, News 11.